Well, well, my friends, the overhaul project on the Axial SEX 10-2 is completed, and I have to say, it's looking pretty good. The body is a 1946 Dodge Power Wagon from Proline Racing, painted in a gloss black, which is looking really nice. Also went back and touched up on a few things, like the front grille in a matte black, kept the CRC bumper on there. Here on the side steps, I did the same thing, matte black. Then I went back and touched up with some chrome accessory items, the breather and the smokestack, which is actually the stuff that's on the Kong Head 6x6 truck that I did a project build on. And it turned out looking sweet on there. Now, the wheels and tires, I did the Super Swamper TSL XLs from Proline Racing, and then I topped off with these All-Star 1.9 beadlock rims, which is kind of like a blackish chrome color, looking pretty sweet. Come here to the back of the bed. I did a little customization on this. I decided to go with that old school wooden rails on the side, made entirely out of popsicle sticks, my friends. And the little dots there is like nails being put together. It's actually just an ink pen that I dabbed on there to get that kind of effect. Following along here in the bed, did a wooden bed here. Same thing with the popsicle sticks. Topped off with an ink pen to give it that, you know, like I drove nails in the back of it. And I got this really cool little toolbox here. It says Home Depot on it, which is actually one of these little gift card holders that you can get at the store there for like $3. And I thought it would, you know, add a nice little touch to the truck there with that on there. Overall, it turned out pretty good. Also, I upgraded the shocks for these 100 millimeter black internal air shocks from Hot Racing. And as you see there, really cool little shocks there. And yeah, it turned out really great. I'm very pleased with how well it turned out and how great this body looks. Just so looks so like mean. I mean, it does. It's got that, you know, semi old school look feel going on to it, and I really like that, my friends. So yeah, so it turned out really good. I didn't use the light buckets, which are supposed to be right here. I didn't use those because actually I messed up on those. You know, when I cut them out, I messed up on that part. But I think without the light buckets, it looks pretty awesome. That's just my opinion. But looking very sweet. And I can't wait to get it out there on the trails and out there on the rocks and see how this thing looks and does all that good stuff. So yeah. So that's the update on it, guys. It's all done, completed. Well, you know, any scale rig is never completed. You always have more stuff you can end up doing with your scale rig. This is just phase one, I guess. I'll get to phase two somewhere down the road. I got some other projects I want to work on. And but yeah, just a sweet little body. I thank Proline for coming up with such a sweet new body to put on the SCX-10s or any of any crawlers, actually. But yeah, all right, my friends. Well, thank you for watching and taking time and watching the videos on this process of putting this body shell together, the shocks, the rims and tires. I hope y'all do like what I have done. If you did, hey, click that like button down below. Let me know that you liked what I've done with the truck and everything like that. And if you want to comment down below, hey, comment. I would definitely appreciate that. So yeah, well, that's it, my friends. The project's done. Now I can get on to some other projects. But of course, I got to do the run video. As soon as the weather clears up, then I can start taking this thing out and seeing what it's going to do. All right, my friends. Well, thank you guys again for watching, and I will see y'all in the next upcoming video.